Hello students of class 8 and 9, this is Vandana Akka and today we are again revising the topic in English grammar. The name of the topic is transitive and intransitive verbs. So let me just brush up. These are the few examples. Okay, we have already done about the transitive and intransitive verbs in our previous classes. This is just a revision that we will be doing. So here are some examples of transitive verbs. Here are the five examples of transitive verbs and the four examples below are of the intransitive verbs. So let's start with the first example of transitive verbs. The first example I have written here is I baked a pizza. Okay. So here, as we always divide the sentence into a subject, verb, object, it is already done here. I is the subject because who is doing the action here? I am the doer. Hence, I is the subject. Baked is the verb. It talks about the action. Hence, it is a verb. And then, I stop reading the sentence. I baked. So, what question will come to my mind? Or if I say that, you know, I baked, then you children will pose a question. What did you bake, Akka? So, what is the question? What? Okay, the question that came to your mind was what. So the answer that you get to this question what is going to be an object. So in this sentence, the answer that you get to the question what did I bake? I baked a pizza. Hence pizza is an object. So we understand that this verb alone cannot stand on itself. It needed an object. Okay, it needed an object. Hence this verb is called as a transitive verb. In the second sentence, we understand, we read, he rode the bike. He is the subject, rode is the verb, okay, and I stop reading, he rode. Then if I just tell you, he rode, you children will ask me the question, what did he ride, Akka? What? Again, the question that came to your mind is what, okay? So the answer to that question is bike, and hence bike is an object over here. This word road, which is a verb here, needed an object, that is bike, and that therefore this verb is a transitive verb. Now in the next, that is the third example, third sentence, again the sentence is we moved the sofa, and I stop reading, we moved. I stop reading after that, we moved. If I tell you children, we moved, the question that you will ask me is, what did you move, Akka? Then I will answer, we moved the sofa. So when I just said we moved, you asked me what, isn't it? So the answer that you will get to the question what will be the object, and what is the object here? Sofa. So the verb needed an object, hence this verb is a transitive verb. In the next sentence, I met Shiva. Okay, I is the subject, met is the verb, and object is Shiva. Now let me again read. I met. Will you ask me the question what? Will you ask me the question will you ask me the question what? No. Then what will you ask me? Akka, whom did you meet? Isn't it? So you will ask me the question whom. So I will say, I met Shiva. Whom did I meet? I met Shiva. Okay, so the answers that you get to the question what and whom, okay, will be the objects in the sentence, and the verb that will require that object will be called as a transitive verb. The last example, the last sentence of transitive verbs, the horse kicked the man. Okay, the horse kicked. Whom did the horse kick? Isn't it? The question that, suppose as we have been doing, I stop asking, I just stop reading this, the horse kicked. Okay, and I do not show the remaining part of the sentence, I just say the horse kicked. So then you will ask me, whom did the horse kick, Akka? Isn't it? Whom did the horse kick? The answer that you will get to the question whom will be an object in the sentence. So again, we got the answer to the question whom in this particular sentence. So in again, that the verbs that need an object to complete their meaning, or to complete the meaning of the sentence, or to give a complete meaning to the sentence are called as transitive verbs, and the questions that you should be getting to get the object or to get the transitive, to know whether the verbs are transitive or intransitive verbs, you are supposed to get only the, pose only the questions as what or whom, nothing else. Okay, answers that you will get to the questions as what and whom will only be the transitive verbs. Now moving towards the intransitive verbs. Intransitive verbs, as I said earlier, they are such verbs that do not need any object. Even though they do not need any object to make the sentence meaningful. They themselves are completely meaningful. Okay, the sentence is completely meaningful even without the object. So let us see how. The first example here, the bell rang loudly. Okay, the bell is the subject, rang is the verb, and loudly. Now can you pose a question as what or whom over here? The bell rang. Will you say what? No. In order to get the answer as loudly, you will definitely not pose the question as what or whom. Okay, so what will be the question that will come to your mind? The bell rang loudly. When you read the whole sentence, what question will come to your mind to get the answer loudly? You will ask the question as how. The bell rang. How did the bell ring? Loudly, isn't it? So hence, how will be the question posed and not what or whom. Hence, this is not, the word loudly is not an object over here. Okay, it is not an object. So the verb rang remains as an intransitive verb. Although it is not needing an object, yet the sentence is meaningful. The verb itself is making the sentence meaningful. Such a verb that doesn't require any object and yet the yet makes the sentence meaningful is called as an intransitive verb. In the second sentence, the book fell down. The book is the subject here. Fell is the verb. Okay. Now if I say the book fell, where will be the question that will come to your mind and not what or whom. Okay. So if the question that comes to your mind is where, then definitely the verb in this particular sentence is not a transitive verb because it is not giving any answer to any object. Hence this word fell or the verb fell is an intransitive verb. Now as you see, loudly in the first sentence is an adverb. Okay, adverb. Then adverb of manner. Then in the second sentence, down is a preposition. In the third sentence now, he spoke. How did he speak? In order to get the answer as politely, you will not ask as what did he speak or whom did he speak. Okay, you will have to pose a different question. And what is that different question? You will say, how did he speak? Then I will say, he spoke politely. So if we are getting the question as how, again you should understand that it is not giving an answer to an object. Hence this verb spoke over here is an intransitive verb because it is not needing any object, yet it is making the sentence meaningful. In the last sentence, the horse walks. There is no other word after the verb. The horse is the subject, walks is the verb, and that's it. The sentence ends there. Yet the sentence is meaningful. The verb walks doesn't need any kind of an object to complete the sentence because itself the sentence is meaningful even without the object. So such a verb which does not require any object and yet it makes the, it is, you know, it is capable of making the whole sentence meaningful is called as an intransitive verb. So today children, we studied or we revised transitive and intransitive verbs. Please go through this video and try to understand it, and if you do not understand, please pose a question on WhatsApp to me and I will be able to help you. And tomorrow we will deal with some exercise. Till then, thank you.